Vita, day 10. What do you miss about being a child, a teenager? About being a child, no responsibilities and no fears. I wasn't afraid of anything when I was a kid, except the dark and heights. but I wasn't afraid by the world. I didn't see there to be a problem back then. I had no responsibilities. I was a free range kid when I was a child in the 70s and 1970s. I could roam around the city and do my thing and be with my friends, and everything was good. Life was exceptional when I was a child, so much more than now. Sadly enough, when I was a child, all I wanted to do was grow up so that I could be an adult and do anything I want. Little did I know how much being an adult actually sucks. So, and not long after becoming an adult and being on my own and stuff, I had that desire to be a child again. So, and for being a teenager, I miss high school. I miss my friends in high school. Believe it or not, a lot of people that don't like school, of course, that I grew up with, they hated school, but I enjoyed it. I really liked high school, and I liked being in the chess club. I liked just everything about it. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed learning. I enjoyed doing things in school. I just really got a kick out of high school. So, there was the computer club, the chess club. It was all, and of course, way less responsibility. So, So today I'm going to watch something that I haven't watched in decades, since the 1970s, I do believe. It's probably, it's the 1970s when I saw it last. And I'm gonna, there's only 15 episodes. They're only 23 minutes each. So I'm going to watch it. I'm going to watch all of it today, later on today. Maybe I'll do a thing about it later, maybe not. I don't know. Whatever. We'll see. We'll see. But yeah, it's a show that I don't know why wasn't a success, if I remember it correctly. It's got a good rating on IMDb. It's ARK 2, ARK, and then II for 2, the Roman numeral 2. It's a different show, but for the 70s, it was pretty darn good, if you ask me. That's if I'm not romanticizing it. I haven't seen it since the 70s, and when I see it, I might think it completely sucks. I completely romanticized The Star-Lost. When I was a kid, I really enjoyed that show because there was nothing else. We didn't have American channels. We just had the two English channels and one French channel that were Canadian, and that was it. And The Star-Lost was the height of programming for kids back then, older kids, anyways. And it sucks. The effects are horrible. The script is horrible. The acting is horrible. The Amish people fix a nuclear reactor by watching videotapes. it's just so outlandishly bad. So maybe that'll happen. Maybe I'll just think this is really horrible and not like it. But I'm hoping to enjoy it. I'm hoping to enjoy it. Yippers! There was a movie that I really liked. I saw it two or three times on TV when I was really young, called Killdozer. And I'm like, I would love to see this. It's, I remember saying that a few years back that I'd love to see this again. Somebody said it was on YouTube, so I found it on YouTube, and I'm like, this is completely horrible. There's no way this giant bulldozer is going to be sneaking up on people. It's just completely stupid and bad. So yeah, we do romanticize things from the past. So yeah. Anyways, that's it. That's all. You have a fabulous day and keep smiling.